Hello, spider peeps. All right, so I've got something different today. This is something that I joined a Kickstarter for a few months ago. It's a BLESharkNano. And here are the two boxes that come with it. What is this device? Well, interesting that we've got an aquatic themed logo of a shark. And this is something that is very similar to the flipper, the dolphin thingy, which is a little naughty device. But it does have some decent uses, and it's quite interesting some of the things it can do. So as usual with the Kickstarter, we have all these unnecessarily wonderful packaging that are normally stretch goals. Very beautiful, but it's sad that we have to throw this away. This is just a silicone case for it. So let's have a look at the SharkNano. So Bluetooth low energy wireless multi-tool. Ooh, stickers! Setup guide. And here's the device. What else have we got in there? We've got nice Wi-Fi signals. I think this is an ESP32 style thing inside this, but I could be wrong. I'm probably not going to take this apart. But yeah, I was a bit late for the party on the flipper. I always wanted one, and now they've got a bit of a reputation. So when I saw this was being kickstarted, I thought I'll have a go at getting my hands on one of these, and managed to do it. So I think this should go in there. Let's do that to start with. Oh, something for the end screen there. I'll save that for after the titles. Okay, so will this turn on? That looks like an on switch. Of course, I'm not going to look at the setup guide. Yay! So a beautiful little OLED screen. Tell you what, let's put this on the desk. Let's zoom in. Can I zoom into that and it not be blurred? Slightly blurred, apologies. Welcome to BLESharkNano. Press any button to start. Let's press this one. Connect to the network and follow the guide. Oh no, I'm going to have to look at the instructions. I'm pushing all these buttons and nothing. So this is a device that you can use for pen testing. You can use it to send IR signals, which is one of the things I wanted to play with. You can also use it to do naughty things like bad Bluetooth, which sort of becomes a keyboard to a phone. So it connects via Bluetooth and sends naughty commands to the device, which of course I won't be using it for. But you can use it to de-auth Wi-Fis, which is a hacking technique that people use to throw people off a Wi-Fi access point. But also on it, which I thought was really cool, there is a thing that allows you to see whether there is a de-auth attack happening. So that's one of the things I wanted to play with this. And there's tons of other stuff. There's games on it, all manner of bits and bobs. And I really should have looked at it a little bit more. What I wanted to do is try and work out how to capture an IR signal. But it looks like it... Oh no, connect to the network and follow the guide. All right, so I need to connect my phone to it, which feels a little dodgy, but let's do it. Okay, so I'm going to use this slightly older phone just in case. Connect to BLESharkNano setup. See what happens. Okay, so that should give me a captive portal. Okay, so the captive portal didn't pop up. But I went to 192.168.4.1 and now I've got the login. So here's the login on this, which I can't read. So the username is BLESharkNano123, catchy. And the password is... Ah, just noticed it tells me to where to go to on the browser there as well. Had I been able to read it, maybe I should have picked something with a bigger screen. Oh well, I hope. Okay, so this has found my Wi-Fi network, which looks a bit dead. So let's connect to that. I'm all set. Press restart to restart your BLESharkNano. Well, how do I press restart? Whoop. Is there a restart button? There is not. Oh, press restart there. What a thicky stupid. Why don't you read what's on the screen, Spidermaf? Okay. Will it restart? Yeah, connecting to Mort. Now it's downloading the firmware, so it's updating itself, so that's cool. Or it's taking over my Wi-Fi network. We'll see. This is version 0.91. It's installing. I mean, in many ways, I should have connected this to a different Wi-Fi network, but hey, let's go with it. Okay, so yeah, so we've got various things to do. So there's Bluetooth. That's the Bluetooth one. I don't want to spam Bluetooth with anything, but there's a Wi-Fi menu. There's an infrared menu. So this is what I want to play with at this point. So there's controlled. Do I click that? No, TV begun. Don't want that one. Remote, learn. So I want to learn new remote. So let's click on that. Is it a TV or is it other? It's other. So I'm going to call this remote one. All right, so I'm just going to use one of these things. So let's do, the infrared's on that side. So let's do that and do on. All right, so back, send, save. So let's click save. That should have, what's it doing? Now I'll do the other one. So let's do off and let's save that as well. Screen's gone dim. I'm wondering whether the batteries are losing it now. So this did arrive. I haven't bothered charging it. So let's just give it a bit of juice. See whether that brings the light on a bit better. It's not doing, is it? I hope that doesn't mean it's gone bad anyway. So scan in and what was it? Hold button 3 to exit. Is it button 3? Hold S to exit. Is this S? Is the middle one S? Okay, hold. Middle one is S. Right. So that's learn. So now if I go to remote 1. So I assume it somehow programmed that into one of them. So, I mean, you know, always read the instructions, Spidermaf. Got this light, which has just got this, the LED puck in this, the RGB one, which you can see in this video, this Alley Hall video that I did. So let's see if I do on and off now. It does nothing. Hang on. Okay, so off and on. So that works on this. So does this zapper work now? Yes. Yeah, so that has recorded. Can you see that red coming on? Hang on. Let's give you the full light show. So I think that one. Did that one turn it on? No, this one turned it on. And so a bit of a red glow on that. And this one turned it off. This teeny little gadget did that, and it does all manner of other crazy stuff as well, but let's not go into those sort of things. But yeah, this is just something I wanted to use to have a play with some pen testing on my own network, and indeed that's the only legal way that you should use these things. But yeah, BLESharkNano. I'll leave a link for this in the description. It looked like it's slightly cheaper on the website at the moment. If you're interested in that, maybe you can purchase one before they all sell out. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed this brief intro video. Now, have you got one of these? What are you going to use it for? Leave a comment. Have you compared this with the Flipper device as well? Do you think this does the same thing or not? Would you trust it? Let me know in the description what you think about it. Anyway, catch you in the next video. Bye. I never did put it in its case, did I? In all the excitement. Oh, hashtag not a dolphin.